Just check على
الو الو جود مورنينج سر. الو
يا وي كان هير يو.
يس نيكست
هاي ون فيوري ذات از ناتي موتا ان ذس پرتیکولر کرنٹ ایئر وی ار گوئنگ فار ذا اٹونومس.
يا وي كان هير يو کلیئرلی.
نيكست
Is it necessary that two autonomous batches should be get passed?
Again, please.
Hello.
Yeah, we can hear you. Please repeat.
Sir, my question is, in this particular current year, we are going for the autonomous. And is it necessary that for filling up the form, tire one, two batches must autonomous, two batches must be pass out or what?
You can type the question there.
Okay.
Open it.
বেঙ্গল কলেজ পলিটেকনিক দেখুন বেঙ্গল নাইস নেক্সট টাইম উই শুড হ্যাভ অনলি অ্যাবাউট 30 পক ওকে স্যার ডান ডিস্ক
আই আর ই ఆయన దానికి ఆన్సర్ చేసాక కాపీ చేసి పెట్టుకుని కొడతాను. ఎవరి ముందు మాట్లాడు మనం కన్నీ లైవ్ లో ఉన్నాం.
తపత్ కుమార్ డే ఓన్లీ 5-6 Always on mobile phones and still they want NBA certification. Purnima? Technology Mula is a Jana. Purnima Institute of Technology.
సార్
స్టేజ్ పెట్టుకోగలరు.
Getting two batches is necessary, whoever it is, whether it is tier 1 or tier 2, getting two batches pass out is necessary. And then somebody is asking about 19th page. I think I have covered it, right? I have covered the 19th page. Dr. Babu, J. Suresh Babu, I have covered it. Anyway, I will, when I go through the DPSR, that time you will understand. Otherwise, I will definitely go through it. Don't worry. So today I will go for Diploma SR and then UG Tier 1, if possible, right? So UG SR, first I will go for Diploma Tier 1, Diploma SR. I think more or less similar scenarios we have. So then we will go for UG Tier 1 also, so that you will have complete picture of NBA accreditation, right? And I find that in couple of colleges, the participants are not there, are like, so please ensure that they are there in the training session, right? The important 3 days have been gone by. So remaining 2 days, we discuss for so many other things also. So ensure that the participants are there. Without participants, and ensure that the participants are there. So this is for the benefit of faculty, that means yourself, and it will help the institute indirectly, right? If you know the process completely, lifelong you can be the expert in the area of institute development, quality improvement, teaching learning process, pedagogy, OBE, everything. I hope you got the clear knowledge about outcomes, pedagogy, the improvement of quality in teaching learning and all. And yesterday we were discussing about innovative methods. Innovative methods may be pertaining to a subject, they may be different. Don't assume that videos already being used, PPTs are already being used, or something else is already being placed, used in some other subject. It is not necessary that some entirely new thing will come as innovative. It is not like that. So suppose I am teaching Chakri's Blackboard, so for me PPT is an innovative way only, right? And innovative methods can be with respect to teaching learning process. That means method of assessment also, method of evaluation also, method of testing also, right? So innovation in any other area, right? If already innovative methods have been placed, so then why people call it as innovative method, right? It is with respect to the subject. You can just simply say thermodynamics, what is the innovative method? Production technology, what is the innovative method they are adopting? Like that you can segregate, right? Innovative method in the sense that new thing that you have been using in your particular course, right? New thing you have been using in your particular course, innovative method means, right? And today we will go for Diploma SR.
Diploma SR, this one.
But things are similar to UG as well as PG, but still I will go for UG SR also, Tier 1 again. So UG SR, Tier 1 and Diploma SR I will carry out today. So that will consolidate your knowledge with respect to NBA accreditation and overall improvement of quality and all. I expect all the faculty are listening to me, right? All the faculty are attending all the sessions are like, right? It is left to you, suppose for a couple of hours or 1 or 2 hours or sometime you need to go for class or like that's okay, but you are expected to be there, right? Frankly, I'm telling you, if you are there, you will be the experts for the next couple of years are like in the areas of outcomes, accreditation process,
teaching learning process, quality improvement, everything, right? Pedagogy. What do you mean by pedagogy? All those things you must be clear about. So please be there. And specific questions people are raising, the specific questions according to your institute, whatever the things that can be presented, you may discuss among yourselves, and finally, still you have a question, I'm ready to answer that, right? And so again, I'm telling you this, vision statement is what you want to become. One statement only, simple statement. Mission statements, we need to have three, like related to the faculty competency, related to the state of the art lab technology facilities, related to the overall maintenance of teaching learning environment. So mission statements will be three, POs will be three to five, POs will be three to five based on like what are the objectives of with respect to the student, what are the objectives, why he is joining the program, for employment, for understanding of the basic and advanced knowledge, and then to be self-employed, to go for higher studies, or to work in a multidisciplinary environment, like that POs can be 3 to 5. And then based on that, we have something like POs. POs are the abilities expected at the end of the program. Outcome in the sense, abilities expected at the end of the program. Even though they are failing in the examination or they are failing in the course, no problem. They may be achieving some certain amount of outcomes, though that is certain amount of abilities, right? So that is outcome-based education. So POs we have, based on that we have PSOs, program-specific outcomes, based on that we have COs. COs means course outcomes. Course outcomes can be about 3 to 6. PSOs already 2 to 4, they have mentioned, and then POs, they have already given 12 in case of UG and 7 in case of diploma. POs 3 to 5, and then mission statements 3 and vision statement 1. So if you are teaching properly in the class and keeping all the records of assessment and all, so that means you are trying to meet PSOs, you are trying to meet POs, you are trying to meet POs, and then you are trying to meet mission accomplished. You are looking towards mission accomplishment, and then finally the vision of the institute is being met. So this trend is there already, right? And then CO preparation already we have discussed about. With respect to the subject, we can have 3 to 6 COs. CO1, so using the action verbs, understand, apply, analyze, or whatever, right? And CO-PO matrix also important. So when you are mapping that with POs, you should ensure that relevance is there. If relevance is there, you should be able to tick it. And then level also. Level 1, level 2, level 3. All the time we are worried about levels. Level 1 is low, level 2 is medium, and level 3 is high. So CO-PO matrix, when you are filling, that time you are expected to give the level. And during CO attainment or PO attainment calculation, you need not worry about the levels. Already we have seen in SAR, right? Somebody is still getting question about that. These levels are at the time of CO-PO, right? Matrix. Then,
somebody.
So we will go ahead with the presentation. So we are talking about diploma engineering program. So we will quickly go through so that we will, whatever the things that are covered, we will not discuss much. So first one is, criteria 9 are there. So we have vision statement, mission, program educational objectives, then program curriculum and teaching learning process, course outcomes and program outcomes, then student performance, faculty information and contribution, then facilities and technical support, continuous improvement, student support system, and governance. So only thing that is not there is first year academics. We do not have first year academics in diploma.
You can increase. Right. Increase.
So name and address of the institute, name and address of the DTE, year of establishment, ownership status. You need to give the details of other academic institutes run by the same. Then details of the program being offered by the institution under consideration. Then accreditation history, name of the department and name of the program. So by now you should be clear about only programs are accredited, and some of them have problems. Like that is that those problems are there everywhere. Like CS, CSC, then mechanical, then civil, then we have electrical or like. Suppose we have five departments or four departments in an institute, there may be a chance that mechanical is meeting all the requirements and civil is meeting all the requirements, or like some may not be meeting the requirements. So there may be a chance. So you need to rectify that error, then only you can proceed for accreditation. It is program based accreditation, not institute based accreditation. Even if you ask for about our institute also, yes, all the we have about four departments. Not all the departments are doing good every time, right? So according to the admission intake, according to the placements, according to the scenario of that means higher education and all, so based on that only, if you are meeting the all the requirements, then only you will be accredited. And also suppose you do not have research or like, so it is basically a 1000 marks question. Question paper is for 1000 marks. Suppose we do not have research, suppose research and consultancy is not there in our institute, suppose, or like, so we will lose about 30 to 40 marks, right? So then suppose somebody say we do not have placements properly, or higher education scenario is not there, about 10 marks or 20 marks, like, right? Suppose our HOD is not having PhD in the relative discipline or something, so we will, so out of 1000, we may be having some negativity with respect to 100 to 150, right? Don't worry too much about these 100 to 150 marks. Remaining 850 marks, you please hang. That is there with every institute. Even reputed universities, they do not have proper placements. Reputed universities, they do not have professor in their department or like. That is there. So you have to overcome, then only you can go for accreditation. Suppose you have a doubt, you please go for pre-qualifier. Let us see what they will respond, what they will ask about this, right? You look for queries, right? So everywhere this kind of problem is there. Somebody told that somebody was telling that research is not there or something. So we will lose certain amount of marks. Suppose we do not have industry linkage. Suppose industry linkage is not there, we will lose about 20 marks or like. So like this, in any given institute, there is negativity of about 100 to 150 marks. There are some regions where we may be lagging, right? So that you should produce as it is, right? Or you need to try to overcome, and then you can apply for accreditation. Everywhere these are there. In our institute also, we have different programs, and all the programs are not doing good at. Alright, so this possibility is there. So you should not be worried about getting accreditation for all the programs. So once for all it must be clear for you, alright? Alright, so today we will go for diploma and UGCER once again. So programs to be conducted for considered for accreditation in this application, so you should mention. Then total number of employees, so minimum and maximum by now you should be clear about. So if there is a change in number of employees, number of faculty, from the starting of the academic year to the ending of the academic year, if there is any change, then only you have the aspect of minimum and maximum. Otherwise, it is one column is sufficient. Right? And regular and contractual, 75% will be called as 75% should be minimum, 75% should be regular as per the ACT norm. SFR, faculty and staff details or whatever is as per ACT norms. If you have ACT approval, so that means you are meeting the minimum requirements. Then in SFR calculation, you can have contractual contractual faculty also if they have more than 1 year experience. Yesterday I had shown you the document. Updated document is also available in NBA website related to SFR calculation. Right? Yesterday we had discussed about that, and if you have any doubt, you can go through that again. Right? So then total number of students, boys and girls, and then total number of students put together for the last 3 years. So apart from the present year, last 3 years also we need. Then contact information of the head of the institution. So and NBA coordinator if he's attends. So we should have NBA coordinator details also given. So then criteria one, vision mission statements of institute and department. So by now you should be clear about vision statement. Vision statement in the sense what you want to become, to be a reputed institute in the region of West Bengal, imparting technical education in various disciplines. Like that it should be. I repeat, to be a reputed institute or to be the best institute in the state of West Bengal or like, imparting technical education in various disciplines. Simple statements, understandable. That must be understandable to the stakeholders. Right, then mission statements based on the facilities one, based on the faculty one, based on the overall environment you can write. Right, by incorporating the state of the art lab facilities, you want to meet the requirement vision statement vision. By having competent faculty in the institute, so you want to meet the vision of the institute. Then by providing excellent teaching learning environment or research environment to meet the vision of the institutes. Like that, mission statements can be three. Then POs. We are expected to write POs. POs are about 3 to 5. About 3 to 5, why he is joining the program. That also we have discussed. And then indicate how vision, mission and POs are published. Where you are publishing these details. So those things you need to discuss about. Already hints are given, website, curricula, posters, etc., and notice boards and all. Right? All those things are clearly mentioned. So yesterday also we have discussed. So then state the process for defining the vision and mission statements. So vision and mission statements and POs, the stakeholders must be involved in, but they may not be having that much time, so you will prepare, get it approved by the stakeholders in 1 or 2 meetings. Right? At the end of every year, we should have the meetings of stakeholders. Already I have told you. Apart from faculty meetings, we should have stakeholders meeting, and we need to minute them. Every year, we need to conduct them. That also I have told you clearly. So suppose in a given year we have a semester starting in June and then ending in December. So at least before starting we will have faculty meeting, in the middle class committee meetings too, then in the end faculty meeting, right? Setting the targets here, setting PO, CO targets here in the faculty meeting, and then ending we will see what kind of processes have been followed and whether everything is in proper place or not. So any problem with the process, teaching learning process, that we will discuss in the end meeting. And after the examinations also we will have one more meeting. So any difficulty in the overall semester and all can be rectified, and the plan for the next semester can be made. Again, couple of 1 or 2 faculty meetings in the middle. Then here we need to have the stakeholders meeting, outgoing student meeting, employers meeting or industry, then alumni meeting, and then parents meeting. Suppose some of them you cannot have or like, so maybe the next year or like you should have, and you should minute them. And then we have a board of studies, academic council and a BOG, and then Autonomous institute means the changes can be made in the subject wise curriculum or like, and then those changes should be put it in the order. Otherwise, if we are affiliated institute, any processes, any problem with the teaching learning process, those should be rectified, and then only you should go for the next. Those changes have to be made in the before the next commencement of the next academic year. And their academic audit also will be helpful for you. Academic audit, already I have told you, academic audit also will be helpful. Some faculty from some department, a senior faculty from one department may go for checking the teaching learning aspects in another department. So possible. So that is possible, that academic audit is the good. Academic audit is a good practice. So at the end of every year or at the end of every semester, it can be conducted. Faculty from a senior faculty from one department will visit another department and check whether all the processes have been in place or not. Properly classes are being taken, documentation that like attendance sheet, evaluation process, assignment scenario, everything is in place or not, any changes have to be done or like. So he will conduct the audit, academic audit, and report it to the HOD. So accordingly actions will be taken. Academic audit and actions taken are also a must, right? So that is how we can have continuous assessment and continuous evaluation. Right, then establish the consistency of POs with mission statements. So POs, we have three to five statements. So then mission statements also we have 3 to 5. So then appropriate ones we will tick mark and also give the levels. Everywhere we are worried about level 2, level 3, level 1. Level 1 in the sense low level mapping or low level matching. Then 2 is moderate level matching. Suppose PEO 1 is talking about employment. In the mission statement also you have talked about employment. So they are matching to each other. They are getting mapped to each other, right? So then you decide whether it is one level, low level mapping or level 2 mapping or like, right? So mapping is also you should be thorough with. So everywhere we are worried about level, low level, moderate level, and substantial level, right? So all these things we have discussed yesterday and then today also. So only marks are different between diploma and UG. So for any academic institute, similar processes have to be followed. So that's why, in order to consolidate your knowledge, in order to have complete knowledge, I am asking you to be there in all the sessions, right? The next criteria is program curriculum and teaching learning process. So yesterday also we have discussed about, so again we will see, state the process to identify the compliance of curriculum in attaining POs and all. Right, so if you are affiliated, whatever the things that are being adopted by the state council or DT, Directorate of Technical, whatever it is, so whatever the processes they are following, you can adopt and you can discuss the same. Program outcomes, the compliance of curriculum with the program outcomes. In the sense they have certain abilities at the end of the program. They need to have certain abilities at the end of the program, like engineering knowledge, disciplinary knowledge, communication skill, ethics and all, right? So the program must have covered all these. So the AECT, these are the guidelines given by AECT. During the design of curriculum, all these things might have been considered. So you should not worry about that. The same process you will write, keeping in mind the program outcomes, the syllabus is designed. Basic science, this much. Advanced knowledge, this much. Modern tools, this much. So, like this, you will discuss same as per the AICTE norms. Alright? So, nothing new we will discuss here. During curriculum design, you have considered all those aspects that are there in program outcomes. So, you just show the relevance and then discuss the same. Right? And then people are worried about contents beyond the syllabus. Contents beyond the syllabus is only for autonomous institutes, I can say. Even affiliated institutes also, they can have content beyond the syllabus. But if you show that, do you have the ability to change the curriculum when you offer the same next time? No, right? So that time you will not show the gaps. Right? We will not move in the same vehicle that is defective, right? First cycle is sufficient, one cycle is okay. So you say that you have found gaps. So next cycle, same with gaps, you will continue. No, right? So that's why showing the more gaps is not required. So that's why they have given clear indication here. In case all the POs and PSOs are being demonstrably met through curriculum, then 2.1.2 will not be applicable. Clearly it is given. So you please depend on that, cash on that, so that overall marks will be 40. This 15 will not be there. Somebody somewhere without prior understanding or like they have been discussing in the institutes about this curriculum gaps and all. Suppose I'm affiliated to West Bengal Technical University or Macau. So I assume that even though there are some deficiencies in the curriculum, we continue with the same. Every time we will not communicate to the university and say, please change the curriculum like this, or this content you please have. No, right? Curriculum may be for 3 years or like that. So next time whenever they are going for, so they may ask for suggestions. So that time we will communicate. Yes, these changes can be made. Suppose still you want to have this 2.1.2. Clearly it is mentioned. 2.1.2 is content, it cannot, you need not worry about 2.1.2. You say that the university curriculum or state councilor curriculum is being followed meticulously, and hence there is no need of 2.1.2, right? And every faculty, they can clearly say, suppose you find gap, so what are the actions taken, like extra classes, extra lectures, extra classes or extra lectures by efficient people, or same person, eminent persons, or some other resource person, or same faculty can teach, right? And so that is content beyond the syllabus. Don't depend too much on content beyond the syllabus. You neglect this 2.1.2 and still you can show some of the works you are doing under contents beyond the syllabus as an added advantage. Even though the syllabus is up to the mark, still we are trying to give more skills to the students. Like that you can suggest. Right? The process of audit is hectic, somebody is saying. Yes, hectic means you should do, sir. AICTE's approval is for running the program. NBA accreditation is to find out the best one among the people who are offering the same course. Hectic, all are hectic only, sir. Dr. S.K. Singh, all are hectic only. Academic processes, you need to carry out. AICTE accreditation is to run the institute. NBA accreditation is for the best people among the lot, right? Best among the lot, right? So the curriculum gaps you can identify, and then what are the timings you have used for bridging that gap, you can identify if you, right? And then there is a chance of using MOOC and SWAYAM also, right? Even we have been offering MOOC programs so that people can uh, attend in order to bridge the gap, right? Then teaching learning process, describe the processes followed to ensure improvement of quality, improving the quality of teaching learning process. So different hints are given, whether you are sticking to the calendar, what about the various delivery methods and all. So same thing what we have discussed yesterday, different processes, what you have been following, here clear cut idea is given, right? What is the assessment you are doing in the laboratory, all those processes have to be discussed, right? Then initiatives to improve the teaching, improve the quality of teaching, quality of semester tests and assignments. So what kind of processes you are following for question paper setting, and then what kind of outcomes they are related to, and then what kind of coverage that is there in tests and assignments. So normally all the outcomes are, all the COs, whatever you have designed for, all the course COs are expected to be meeting meeting the requirement with respect to questions in various tests, class tests and all. Then quality of experiments. So so from now onwards, I wish to share one thing from here. So suppose I have three outcomes, the course outcomes. So this is for only a guideline. This is like a in my perspective, don't make it as a formula. There are 2 to 3 or 3 to 5, like CO1, based on CO1 I will have class test 1, based on 2 class test 2, based on 3 I will have assignment, or like so, like that all the things are covered in very. If you don't cover in the any class test or assignment, they are expected to be covered in the term and examination, and so it is ensured. So the way we are following, it is assumed that all are being covered. So we need not specifically mention in the question paper that this is related to CO1, this is related to CO2. You need not mention that in the question paper. This is not required at all. You need not mention COs in the question paper, please. It is directly or indirectly, whatever the waves we are following, they have been in the same pattern, requirement pattern. But here I can suggest you that don't combine the questions just like that. Don't mix the questions from now onwards, at least. Don't mix the questions, and don't say that some question is out of the syllabus or something. Like intelligent question I have given you, some very innovative question I have given you, you should not have that trend. So simply they must be related to any of the COs. No mixing or like, so that individual COs you want to calculate, you can calculate easily, right? No mixing of questions also from now onwards, at least, right? Then quality of experiments, experimental methodologies, innovative experiments included, including industry attachment, virtual labs, then relevance to outcomes. So innovative experiments, then experimental methodologies. So innovative experiments in the sense, suppose some old equipment like Redwood viscometer is lying there. So I will show it in self-learning, right? And what can be the innovative experiment based on that? So some old Redwood viscometer is lying, nobody is using that. So still I will use it for some innovative experiment. I will give the question, I will give the assignment, or I will ask the students to identify suitable lube oil or suitable viscous oil. Right? Identify suitable viscous oil for a specific application. So they keep on experimenting. That is innovative experiment only. Right? The same with Redwood viscometer. Simple Redwood viscometer, I can use it for innovative experiment. Example, find out the proper lubricant oil for a specific application. Right? They will conduct experiments and all. So this is self-learning, learning beyond the syllabus only, or innovative experiment. Right? Suppose some flash point and fire point apparatus is lying just like that. And we may not be using beyond the class hours or like that. Right? So we may give we may give a innovative experiment, we may design some innovative experiment like identification of proper fuel or proper lube oil, proper oil or proper fuel for specific application. So they will try to identify different oils, and then they will try to identify the flash points and fire points. So this should come from, this should be related to your own discipline, and this should come from your side, right? Like these are only examples. And another one, I have bomb calorimeter. Suppose we have bomb calorimeter, identify suitable solid fuel. 1 or 2 years, I can say this one as a innovative experiments. Further, identify suitable gaseous oil, identify liquid fuel. So many options are possible, right? Then quality of students, projects and report writing. Quality of students, projects and report writing. So yesterday we had seen the students' projects should be application oriented or review oriented or research oriented or industry linked oriented. Right? Just like the study oriented projects, don't go for from, at least from now onwards. Right? Process for monitoring and evaluation. So what kind of process you are following for allotment of projects? So what kind of projects they are doing, and what is the competency of the faculty? All those things we must be discussing herein. Then processes to assess individual and team performance. Processes to assess individual and team performance. So what kind of measures we are following? Maybe presentations or reviews 2 times in a semester or like that you can follow. Papers published or awards, recognition received by projects at state or national level, right? That is also possible. So we need to discuss all those. Yeah, COs are assumed to be attained through class test, assignments and term and examination put together. Don't worry that internals only have to be, they need to cover all the COs are like, don't worry about that. Internal, external, everything put together, they must be covered. You should have minimum understanding where they are being covered. You don't please confuse the students by mentioning the CO name in question paper. They must be given the training related to COs and POs. So that can be there, but don't confuse them by giving the CO numbers in question papers. Right? Together, midterm examination and end semester, COs have to be attained. Individual CO attainment, don't worry about. In SAR, are they mentioned anywhere? Are they asked for? In example, they have mentioned. I understand. Anywhere they have asked for individual COs? No, right? Industry interaction and community services. So what kind of industry interaction we have, industry supported labs if you have, then industry training or internship. So internship or industry training projects, reports you should collect at the end of that. And you need to have some assessment process for that. Why? Because based on these only major projects may be there. That itself is industry linkage. Most of the institutes lose this. Most of the institutes neglect this aspect. Some industry training they have gone, and then they are not collecting the reports at all. Even if they are collecting, they are throwing somewhere. And projects, again, they are thinking differently. No. From that itself, some project can be evaluated, sir. Right? COs need not be the university question papers. University question papers may be related to COs only. We need to understand which CO it is related to. That's it. Yeah, accreditation for PG courses. Along with that, do you wish to submit UG? No, sir. UG is separate, PG is separate, diploma is separate, MBA separate. Separately, you please do. don't put together all of them, right? Somebody is putting good question. If levels are not being used for CO attainment, what they are for? Yes, at that point they are required, sir. COs, what kind of level they are achieving, or they are, what kind of level of how better they are towards POs attainment, that is required that time, right? Right, levels are required. Levels are required, right? So even though you are not using in CO attainment, PO attainment, no problem. CO's levels are required. Why? Because how best they are related to the PO attainment indirectly or directly. So that proper understanding will be there using that CO-PO matrix. Or you want to multiply with level and get the output, so that is left to you. So simple questions people are asking. You please follow the sessions, and you are all excellent teachers, good teachers. Suppose somebody is asking, sir, in university examination we don't know which question is attempted by students and how much marks we have got. I understand. So is it related to CO attainment, individual CO attainment? No. Does that say individual CO attainment you cannot discuss? So somebody was asking for individual CO attainment. In internal examination we can have, but external examination we don't know, right? So that's why individual CO attainment nobody is worried, nobody is asking for. You should not be worried about. Only the, but you can comment on in the outcome assessment report at the end of the course. You can comment on what kind of CO1 is achieved, how much amount of CO2 is achieved based on internal examination, or if you are autonomous, that time you can give the assessment. But overall you cannot give individual CO assessment. So that's why cumulative CO assessment only you please follow, right? I hope you have got very good understanding. Very good. So this question you are able to get means you are following my lectures. So individual CO attainment is not required as far as SAR is concerned, but still you can comment in the with respect to individual CO assessment based on internal examinations. External examination, university, somebody else will be correcting. We will not be knowing whoever is what attainment they have got in a particular question or like. So information access facilities and student centering learning initiatives. So what kind of information facilities we have, and what kind of student centric learning activities, MOOC, anything they are doing, webinar, anyway they are following, NPTEL, and then any other learning activity, learning initiatives. So whatever the project, whatever the experiments you are not using in regular courses, those experiments you can use for self learning. And packages, some advanced packages are available, or some softwares are available for free. Those packages you can download on a machine and put it in a computer lab, so that you can show it under student centric learning or self learning. Suppose NPTEL videos related to thermodynamics course or some other course, you can put on a machine and keep it in a library, in libraries, and you say that this is the tool used for self learning, right? PGSAR discussion, the similar things are there in PGSAR also. Somebody is trying to ask me repeatedly about PGSAR. We will do it. Please pay attention. Same things are there in PGSAR. Please attend the lectures properly. You will understand everything. Technical staff or lab assistant in the department, if it is there, yes, it is required. It is required. Faculty may not be conducting the experiments, right? He may be explaining the experiments, he may be explaining the theory behind the experiment, he may not be conducting the experiments, right? So technical staff is a must. Information access facilities and student training, already we have discussed. New initiatives for without meeting the regulations of ACT, how you have got the approval. So according to the ACT norms, that's regular faculty's requirement, whatever it is there, you should meet. Then only you have got ACT approval. Or without that, you have got ACT approval? No. People are asking questions related to ACT approval. If you are ACT approved institute, whatever the mandatory requirements are there, that must be same for NBA. You are already ACT approved institute, so whatever the regulations you have got, so the same will be applied for NBA. That minimum faculty criteria or minimum SFR criteria, same as that of ACT approval. Here you should not have fresh question related to regular faculty and all. Then new initiatives for embedding professional skills. So what kind of initiatives we have for employability skill enhancement, already I have mentioned. So we have professional skill development, soft skill development. Professional skills means apart from the regular curriculum or syllabus, you may need to have additional skills for improving the employability. Like for mechanical engineers, we have some CAD, AutoCAD or Pro-E or something else. So those things can be given to the student. Those skills can be embedded in students. So that you may be doing, faculty, our own faculty, institute faculty may do, or using external sources. You can call external people, they may pay that the money, registration fee for the training. You will be providing the facilities, room and classroom for that training activity, right? Professional skills training is also possible. Same way, soft skill training is also possible. Then, new personality development, that means soft skills and all. One minute. Soft skill development. Soft skill development is also possible, like communication skill development or presentation skill development. External agencies you can use, so the same processes you can discuss here. Then co-curricular and extracurricular activities, NCC, NSS, extracurricular and any related dramatic cell or something. So all those things can be under extracurricular. Co-curricular, design competitions, mechanical engineering association, coding association, programming association, depending on the program you have, so you can have good number of co-curricular and extracurricular activities. So those things you have to discuss. In every section you need to discuss in paragraphs or bullet points. Please ensure that you need to discuss using paragraphs or bullet points in every section, right? So that is second criteria. It is for about 200 marks. Main thing is that criteria too, program curriculum and teaching learning process. So then we have course outcomes. So course outcomes for individual courses we need to identify. Then clearly it is mentioned, number of course outcomes should be from 3 to 5. Clearly it is mentioned, right? 3 to 5, number of course outcomes for each course, it should be from 3 to 5. And we need to give this, this statement, for all the courses. This is for a particular course and how they are related to POs. We should give POs, and then you see PSO1, PSO2 are already given here, so you can club with them. And then POs, we have 7 only for diploma, and then PSOs can be clubbed together in the same matrix. This is for a particular course, and then same should be there for all the courses. Then cumulative one, you can have program level PAO, CS format, PS format, CO matrix. We can have for all the courses. C101, that means first semester first course to last semester last course, all the attainment, that means mapping level with levels also, right? Then we have CO attainment and then PO attainment details, describe the processes, what kind of processes you add up. So the same examination pattern you should discuss here. Examinations, how many examinations you have, internal, external, how many lab tests you have, what kind of project evaluation scenario you have, all those things we should have, we should describe. And then CO attainment, yesterday we had seen CO attainment, that should be discussed here, what kind of CO attainment we have. So most of you, so, and based on the CO attainment, so next target level has to be set. So suppose 1.9 is set, 1.9 is the target achieved. So 1.9, above 1.9, it should be the target. Already we have discussed. So once for all, I will tell you the CO attainment. So to all of you, please be there. CO attainment, I will discuss one more time. CO attainment. Suppose I have some thermodynamics course. For that, I wish to calculate the CO attainment. So it is based on internal. It is based on internal examination and external examination. Based on internal examination and external examination. So the weightage is as per the AACT, as per the university norms or directorate norms. That means state council norms. So it depends on the state council. Somebody has 70-30, somebody has 80-20, somebody has 50-50. So it depends on. So we will take the example of 80% external weightage, so into plus, so internal 20% weightage, 80 internal and 20% internal. So we are taking it as an example. So for something, 80% into something and 20% into something. What is that something? So level 1 or level 2 or level 3. Here also external, level 1, level 2, level 3. With respect to external examinations, we need to decide the level achieved. So whether it is level 1, level 2 or level 3. With respect to the internal mass, we need to find out the level achieved. Level 1, level 2, level 3. So suppose, what is the guideline for internal thing? Internal, suppose I have, what is the guideline for internal thing? So, in order to identify the level of 1 or 2 or 3 with respect to the internal mass, what is the guideline? So that is like example, level 1 can be like 60% of the students crossing 60% mark. Level 2, 70% of the students scoring more than 60% mark. Level 3, 80% of the students scoring more than 60%. So you can change this 60% to 40% or like, so depending on your program and institute. So, but that should be common throughout, right? Suppose I say 70% of my students have crossed 60% marks with respect to the internal examination. I will take the level as 20% into 2. 20% into 2. So with respect to internal examination. Then again with respect to the external examination, 80% into, so with respect to the external examination also some criteria is given. So this is examples only, but similar ones you can have, right? 60% level, 60% of the students scoring more than board average. Somebody was telling board average is not possible. No, you should get the board average. This is our own faculty who has been correcting there. Our own faculty are moderators there. Our own faculty has, they are acting as chief examiner or like, so we should get, officially also we should get. Then 60% scoring more than board average, that is level 1. 70% scoring board average, it is level 2. 80% is good. So according to that, we assume that we have got about 2 or like. So then 20% into 2, that is 0.4 plus 80% into 2, that is 1.6. So total, sorry,
So based on internal, plus external, based on internal and external. So internal 20% into 2 we have finalized, so that is 0.4. Then plus external 80% into 1 to 3 level we have to finalize. What is the level we can say with respect to the external examination? Suppose 60% are scoring the more than the board average level 1, 70% scoring the board average level 2, 80% scoring more than board average, that is level 3. Suppose we have level 2 for this example, if you have level 2, so 80% into 2, that means around 2 or like 0.4 plus 1.6, we are getting around 2. So this is the CO attainment for my course. So this is CO attainment. Right, CO attainment based on internal mass, we have identified the level 1 to 3 out of 1 level we have identified, out of with respect to the external mass we have identified one level between from 1 to 3. Right, so accordingly you will have the course outcome attained. So this is CO attainment. Suppose I have attained 2, so next time when I go for the next offering the same course, I can have the target 2.02 or like or 2.1. So that is target for next time, right? This is for course, individual courses. So suppose same course is being taught by somebody else, they may have different course outcome attainment, right? Please. Right, and here clearly it is given, program shall have set course outcome attainment levels for all the courses. So targets have to be set, not targets, so the levels can be set. These are only examples, so the levels should be set. Suppose I want to change this 60, 70, 80 to 40, 50, 60, so that should be same throughout the program. So some courses are interlinked, so obviously same, it should be same throughout the institute, right? So these are only examples. So next time target, if you are going for, it should be higher than the achieved. Suppose it is 2 is achieved this time, so 2.02 should be the target. So those targets can be different based on the subjects, right? So target may be, here it is clearly mentioned, the target may be stated in terms of percentage of students getting more than class average or something, right? Are set by the program. So they are asking for individual attainment, right? Individual attainment. So this is given as an example, right? They are asking for this individual course outcome, CO attainment also is okay, but they are asked, right? So here in the CO attainment, when we need to go for the overall, we are expected to give the overall CO attainment. So this is overall CO attainment based on internal examinations and external examinations, 60% plus 40%. So suppose you want to calculate the individual assessment against the maximum mark. So suppose you want to, that also is there. Some cases they are asking for this and some cases they are not asking. I understand your idea. So individual course outcome attainment you can calculate based on the maximum mark, against the maximum mark or against the class average, right? So here hints are given clearly, but this is not adapted in UG and PG. So newly they have included this in January 2019, they have added. Right? So this is not there for UG and all again. So that's why, so depending on the program, you need to do the calculation. So this is again based on the, this is based on the class average. Right? This is based on the class average.
right? So suppose you say somebody is asking for individual course outcome attainment you want to calculate, and overall attainment also you can calculate. So there should not be any confusion related to the measuring of CO attainment through internal assessment. Already it is clearly given. The examples indicated are for reference only. Programs may appropriately define their level. Individual attainment, they may be calculated and then they can be kept it in their course file only. They need not be given here in SAR. Course outcome attainment itself is sufficient in SAR, right? So that is why the assessment of CO attainment, the heading is the CO attainment. Heading is CO attainment only. Record the attainment of course outcome of all courses with respect to the set attainment level. So we are expected to give only course outcome attainment for all the courses. Individual course set outcome attainment, you can keep it in your course file. If you put it here again, so it will be a very bulky one. So this is not there for UG and PG, UG and others. So this is only included recently. That is, earlier we used to calculate, even I have calculated individual CO attainment, but overall CO attainment only we will project. So the process is, it is ensured that individual COs are attained. That's why I'm asking, the question should be related to COs only. Right. In board examination, how much they have done and all, we cannot tell, right? So obviously, those CO attainment, individual CO attainment is pertaining to internal marks only. Then attainment of program outcomes and program specific outcomes. So describe the assessment tools, processes for program assessment, provide the results of calculation of each PO and PSO. So POs and PSOs are calculated based on direct assessment and indirect assessment. Suppose direct assessment means through examinations. Suppose I have for a particular PO, four courses are eligible. Suppose I want to calculate PO 1 attainment. I want to calculate PO attainment. With PO 1, there are four courses. For PO 1, suppose we have four courses. So we will consider them and then consider their attainment like 2.1 or 2.2 or something, and then we calculate and divide it by 4. This is direct assessment from courses. Direct assessment from courses, as mentioned here. So summation of all the attained levels divided by number of courses. It is through examinations or through direct assessment. Through direct assessment in the sense that is through examinations based on the courses related to that particular PO by that number of POs. So maybe 2 or 2.2 like that, right? So then we have indirect assessment. Indirect assessment in the sense through surveys, through feedback. Feedback can be taken from all the stakeholders. So faculty, student, industry or alumni, industry or employer, then alumni, then parents. So we need to get the feedback from all of them with respect to POs. We need to get the feedback. Feedback frame has to be defined with respect to POs. PO 1, PO up to PO 7 are given. So level 1 to 3 are given, low level, moderate and high. So they will tick, and then average we will consider. And then indirect attainment also we may have level 2 achieved or like. So direct weightage we will give some 80% or like 80% into, so that calculation is already given here. So from direct assessment, so PO attainment will be 80% of the direct assessment plus 20% of the indirect assessment. So we will have the calculation 80% into 2 plus 20% into something. So based on that, 80% into something plus 20% from indirect assessment, and 20% into this 2 is equal to some number. So 80% into 2.2
this direct assessment will come here and indirect assessment 1-1 will come here. So finally around 2.1 or 2.1. Right? So this is the method to calculate PO attainment. Please friends, you might have understood by now PO attainment level, 80% of direct assessment plus 20% of indirect assessment, that is 1.8 plus 4, that is 2.1. So programs may decide 5 attainment levels instead of 3. So that's the last one, that is a different issue. So we can say PO1 is high, PO2 low, PO3 medium, like that. So like this we can have attainment, we can discuss attainment level. Suppose PO1 we have got 2, PO2 we have got 1, PO3 we have got as 2.3, right? PO4 we have got around 2.2. So like this we can calculate all POs, and we can say clearly whether it is high, low or medium according to the levels between 1, 2, 3, right? And when we set the target next year, suppose how to set the target, suppose we have achieved 2, so we will put the target as 2.02 or 2.04 as the next target. Suppose we have got PO1 as 1, so we will say 1.05 as the next target, like that. So the targets can be reset based on the achievement, right? So suppose you are not meeting the target, suppose I have set the target 2.02, still I have come, next time I have come at 1.9, what can be the action taken? What can be the action taken? Like suppose communications program outcome we are getting less than the target, so we can say more concentration is given on language lab, more concentration is given on communication lab, like that. More concentration is given on communication lab, right? Suppose I say modern tools PO is coming short of the target. You can say stress is given on modern tools. More stress is given on lab activities. More stress is given on project work. Like this you can have, right? So we will break for tea for 15 minutes and we will continue. So we will break for tea. So again we will discuss from PO4. Criteria 4. So we will break for tea. Please come back. Ensure that all are there. So all are attending the sessions. So I will take the questions. So please take a break. I will take the questions. I will take the questions.